need a boy who can cuddle with me all night. Give me one, love me long, be my sunlight. Tell me lies, we can argue, we can fight. Yeah, we did it before, but we'll do it tonight. Yeah, that fro black boy with the gold teeth. Your dark skin looking at me like you know me. I wonder if you got the G or the B. Let me find out and see you coming over to me, yeah.
Go home yesterday.
11:30.
11:30, and it's like
8 p.m. right now.
This is the function three.
That's crazy.
They have you look.
Yeah.
Bring you look. You know what is this for glasses? Yeah, but it's empty fog day.
What?
Yeah, try.
No way.
Then try to make it hot.
What?
No, Mario just told me to wipe this onto my lenses. It's actually anti-fog coated.
Whoa!
Amazing.
Defaga aloloa pusa. This will anti-fog your lenses.
Oh, thank
nice
you.
Nice job.
Thank you.
That's my thumb I put there.
Oh, yeah, that was you? You're so artistic. I love it. I was wondering who it was.
Dr. Mendoza approves this message.
The test case starts at 8:15. Got till 11:30 to complete it. And what do I expect? I'm going to prep teeth numbers 12 and 14 for his zirconia respiratory.
You know it's hard to define in these times, but I got nothing but love on my mind. I need a baby while I'm in my prime. Need an adversary to my down and rare.
So we just got our start check for this appointment. This is what we're doing today. We have 3.5 hours, so shot clock on. Back in the first year, we used to do the test press just for one tooth and then one temporary for the tooth. Now we're upping the stakes. We're doing 2 crown preps on 12 and 14, and then we have to do a temporary bridge for all 3 of these teeth to fill in the missing space right here, tooth number 13. First thing we're gonna do, and I'm just gonna go around the entire tooth and reduce it 0.7 to 1 millimeter. Let's go, because there's a lot to do and not a lot of
okay and everything's all right. Let me in nothing, because I'm not wanting anything but you loving your body and a little bit of your brain. This day's away too lonely.
How much have you reduced over there?
I'm trying to stay more on like 0.5, because yesterday when I practiced, I like reduced like a huge J margin.
Yeah.
Trying to do the opposite today.
Nice. Okay, so we completed the rough axial reduction on both 12 and 14. But step 2, I'm going to switch to a skinnier burr and then do the interproximal reduction. We'll just go through in between the 2 teeth. Next thing we're going to do is reduce the occlusal, making sure to follow the groove pattern of the natural teeth. Now done with the outline of the entire tooth, next thing we're going to do is put the functional cusp bevel, and because it's on the maxillary tooth, it's going to be on the lingual side, the tongue side.
I want someone to love me.
Okay, we're going to look over the entire tooth, try and get the specifications on point as close to ideal as possible. Drop the RPM from 200K to like 50 or 100K, so it's easier to make the prep in its entirety very smooth.
This is the final preparation. This isn't the best work that I've done, but definitely, I think, enough to pass. Groove pattern on the molar isn't as ideal as I'd wanted to, but the canine's doing all right.
Before faculty grade, we actually get to grade ourselves. For the preparation, we're graded on 3 criteria. Occlusal reduction, axial reduction, and the margin.
It's time to get graded.
Dr. Mendoza, are you grading today?
Yes, I am.
Okay, here's my preparation.
Actually, not bad. Very well instrumented. No damage to the adjacent seat, except for the canine. It has a little nick in it right there. Premolar is a little too parallel, so I'm going to have you go back and taper it a little bit. Occlusal clearance is fine.
Yeah, okay.
So your occlusal clearance, I like it. And your pit and groove pattern, just a little bit off.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Extra reduction, minor damage to the adjacent tooth, and two parallels, the premolar. Margin placement is good. So okay. Taper the premolar a little bit more.
Sure.
Do that before you do your provisional so that you have minimal trouble with it.
Okay.
Okay?
I will. Thank you so much.
Let's go, Andrew. Let's go.
I'm actually trying to do my stunt.
It's only 9:50.
Yeah, how long it takes to make a stunt?
I mean, it depends how many you do.
Hopefully it's not 9 again.
Before even stepping into this building today, we had to do some prep work. And that included these casts. And we took an impression of tooth number 13, the one that's missing in the mouth, this one, and then wax it onto the cast. Why we did this is so we could make a putty what the finished product is supposed to look like, and then using this putty we can put the temp material into the putty and use this as a mold to put onto our typodont to give us a full mouth of teeth. So the first one chipped on the mesial 12, but that's okay, let's try again. Well,
the problem here is that I didn't put Vaseline on the tooth, so therefore it was really sticky and there's a higher chance of the temporary breaking. So I'm gonna do it again, but I'm gonna put Vaseline on it.
Nope, 14 distal blown out. Before moving on to our third attempt though, let's ask Mario how. He is always the first to finish.
Mario, before you leave, please.
No, come. Tell us mortals, bro. Come here, bro. I need to interview you. Hey, how are you always the first one to finish? For my row, how are you so fast? Would you compare yourself to the Flash or Superman? Or are you more into Marvel comic characters? So fast! You're lucky I'm filming, bro. If I wasn't filming, psh. Man, if I didn't film, psh, I would have been out of here 2 hours ago. Good job, man.
Thank you. Oh my god. It worked.
All right, everyone. Third time's the charm. For extra good luck, I need your help. Let's all hit the like button on the count of three. 1, 2, 3.
Ugh, not enough people hit the like button. Now I have to do it again.
Andrew, did it work out?
No.
Why not? Yeah, my distal lingual molar also. Last two times.
Attempt 4. I fixed up the margin where there was problems. There seemed to be a slight J margin there, so I smoothed it out.
I believe that will do the trick.
I'm out of proton, so this has to be the one.
Okay, well I got you.
No, this is the one.
Okay, this is the one.
This is the one.
This is the one. Oh, this looks like the one. Get into that interproximal space.
We're going for it. All right, this is the one. Everyone wiggle their mouse over to the like button right now and press like.
Wiggle.
We got it.
Finally, we can change the camera angle. Okay, now that that's finally done, it's 10:48 on my clock. We're going to switch to the acrylic burrs. First one I'm gonna use. Is this conical one? As you can see right now, this is very rugged. There's a lot of edges on it. It just doesn't look very much like the actual tooth. What I'm gonna do is take off the excess and also smooth it out all the way around and make sure it has a really nice fit. Already looking a lot better. Gonna switch to this one, kind of the scariest looking one. Looks like straight up a saw. Strength of this one is that it's really thin, so you can get into the embrasures with it. Now I have a really nice rough outline of this prep. It's actually an example for what the final one has to look like, because for the middle one, there's a bunch of different ways that you can shave this down. There's like a hygienic way where you shave a lot of it down and leave a lot of space between the pontic and the gum. There's a conical way that we had to do in Sim Lab and get signed off. The one we're doing right now is called the modified ridge. I'll show you right now.
How you doing over here, Champ?
Good.
Whoa, babe, that looks so pretty.
Just don't get too close.
No, it's so shiny already.
Thank you.
Amazing.
Thanks. So on the facial, it looks very much like the actual tooth. Very aesthetic. Lingual side, it's more open, smaller, so easier to clean. What an ideal pontic.
Huh? Do you have this metal interproximal strip?
Metal interproximal strip, sorry.
Thanks.
Whoa, that's crazy. That's so good.
Why is it crazy?
It's just like, looks really good.
Thank you. Some might say it's gorgeous, right?
Yeah, it's gorgeous.
Alright, so I made sure it fits onto the teeth correctly. Now I'm just gonna give it a final polish and I'll show you the final product. It's gonna look really good. To polish, I'm changing from this burr to this yellow one. Kind of feels like a hard felt, rubbery. Final last step. We're gonna grab some of this fabby luster. Ooh. This makes it super shiny. Coat it with this, then wipe it down with alcohol, and I'm gonna put it into the mouth. Alright, let's get it braided.
Oh man, right in time.
Good occlusion. Margin's a little bit open.
I agree.
But the contours are nice.
And it's really shiny.
And polish it good. All right. So that occlusion is good. 10.
Yes.
Margin's a little bit open.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the contours 10.
Great.
Not a bad effort.
Yay. Thank you, sir.
Have a good afternoon.
You too. Yeah. Did you get
there
it?
There you go.
Did you get it? Did you get the piece?
I got a 7, 7, 7, what is 21
out of 1?
You
needed
a
21.
There you go.
You made it?
I hit it.
Yes,
go. Only 5 this time. That's 4 less than last time.
There you go. That's like a almost 200% improvement. Don't feel right when it's late at night.